Hi, Mr. Writer. I hope you enjoy the show.
Listen up, y'all, cause this is it. The beat that I'm banging is delicious.
Burgalicious definition, make them boys go loco. They want my treasures so they get their pleasures from my boat. So you can see me, you can't squeeze me. I ain't easy, I ain't sleazy. I got reasons why I tease them. Boys just come and go like seasons. Burgalicious. But...
Once upon a time, back in ancient Greece, Theseus ruled the city of Athens, and Creon ruled the city of Thebes. Enraged, Theseus marches on Thebes and easily conquers it. While scanning the battlefield of dead soldiers, Theseus discovers two wounded enemies. The prisoners were named Palamon and Arcite, who were cousins and sworn brothers.
Hey, you two, come with me! Sit up!
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine.
I want me.
Oh my goodness, look how beautiful she is! Ooh, ooh!
Kill him?
Yeah, kill him. Now check mommy outside.
Ooh, check out Shawty with the cake.
She's just a girl and she's on fire. Hotter than a fantasy. Lonely like a highway. She's living in a world and it's on fire. Catastrophe, but she knows she can fly away. Oh, she got both feet on the ground and she's burning it down. Oh, she got her head in the clouds and she's not backing down. This girl is on fire.
First, she's mine.
I just saw her. What are you talking about?
I saw her first.
Come on, be honest.
Bro, I saw her first. I saw her first. I said she was beautiful and then I woke you up.
No, I was sleeping. I sniffed her out and then came and saw her.
She's mine. I took
it. Stop!
Perotheus, a friend of both Arcite and Theseus, talked to Theseus about freeing Arcite. Theseus agrees to this plan, adding that Arcite is banished from Athens forever. If he dares to enter Athens, he will be arrested and killed. Arcite is jealous of Palamon because Palamon can see Emily in jail every day. Palamon is upset because he thinks Arcite will take Emily by force.
Can't hide. So many, and it's turning on me in-
inside out. I know a woman's nature. There's nothing you can save in me. I run every time. We got two tickets, but they're one way. Now we're with it, so I can't say no.
After being banished from Athens for many years, Arcite has a dream. In this dream, Mercury, a god, tells Arcite to return to Athens for Emily. Arcite listens and does just what Mercury says.
You know what? I'm tired of prison. I'm tired of this. Screw it.
Alma?
Arcite? Emily's mine.
No, she's not. She's mine.
She's mine.
No, she's mine.
After Theseus breaks up this duel, he talks with his queen, the Duke, and Emily to decide what to do about Arcite and Palamon. They come to an agreement, and Theseus tells each of them that they have exactly 50 weeks to raise a strong army, and when 50 weeks are up, they will fight. The winner of this battle will get Emily's hand in marriage.
Alright guys, so listen, we got a big battle tomorrow night against Arcite. He thinks he's big and bad and cool because he's the quarterback of the football team, even though they're not really that good. Also, he doesn't show up to anything. He's so inconsiderate. So we gotta beat him into the ground. Everybody got that? Also, he has red hair, which is really bad. He might as well be blind because all the stupid comments he has in class. So tomorrow night, you gotta come out here hard and beat him into the ground. Everybody got that?
All right, soldiers. We got a big battle coming up. Palamon thinks he's hot and take him to the curb. He's got a big fro. He thinks he's a state champ. He lost in the regional. And he's Greek. You gotta take him out. Alright, soldiers?
Yeah. Venus, goddess of love, I pray to thee and hope to be victorious tomorrow in the name of love. Emily is a beautiful woman, and I ask you to help me receive her hand in marriage.
I got you, homie.
Mars! Mars!
Over here.
I'm Mars. I come to thee for myself to be victorious tomorrow. Pray for me.
We in this.
We in this?
On the same night, Emily goes to the temple of Diana, who is the goddess of chastity, to pray. Diana appears and tells Emily that she must marry either Palamon or Arcite. Emily accepts this news and goes back to her chamber. After Palamon, Arcite, and Emily go to bed, the gods begin talking. Saturn, Venus's father, tells her that Palamon will have Emily's hand in the end, despite Mars's help to Arcite.
This battle is gonna be so sick, yo.
So pumped.
So pumped for this battle.
Yeah,
oh, yeah.
Great.
Mm-hmm. Feasting it up right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, woohoo.
Yeah.
Introducing Palamon the Magnificent, weighing in at 4,000.
£1,000! Yeah, woohoo! You go! Introducing Arsite the Great!
Arsite!
Weighing in at 3,000 pounds!
Arsite!
Let's go! As Arsite celebrates his defeat, Saturn claims it's not over and makes the ground shake, which causes Arsite to fall off his horse.
Yeah, that's right, homie. I'm the winner.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
That's right.
That's right.
Arsite, how are you feeling?
I think this is the end.
If there was someone to marry Emily, it'd be you.
After Arsite dies, Emily and Palamon get married.
Gathered here today to join these hands in holy matrimony. You may kiss the bride.
I trow there netteth little sermoning, to make out assent to this thing. Come near and take your lady by the hand. Betwixt and hem was mad anon the bond, that height matrimoine or marriage, by all the council and the baronage. And thus with all bliss and melody hath Palamon y-wedded Emily. And God, that all this wide world hath wrought, send him his love that hath it dear abought. For now is Palamon in all well, living in bliss, in riches, and in hell. And Emily him loveth so tenderly, and he her serveth all so gently, that never was there no word him in between of jealousy or any other teen. Thus ended Palamon and Emily, and God save all this fair company. Amen.
In other words, Palamon and Emily live a happy life, deeply in love.
The Knight's Tale portrays the use of lust and wrath as two of the seven deadly sins. Thank you.
dreams.